Well, another film that we did for HBO was to do a film of a very poor family. This one, my brother having died some years before, I made with Susan Froemke. And there are several moments in that film that are totally unforgettable. There's a moment when the little boy, mind you now, this is a film of a black family, of an extended black family, very, very poor in Mississippi, in the Delta region. And the little boy, who's a great grandson of grandma, who's the main character of the film, she's talking to him one day about what he wants to be when he grows up. And full of smiles, he says, "I want to be in jail." Sometimes moments like that really tell it all. You know? And of course, the father and none of the male population is around. They're in jail, so a number of them. Perhaps his father, I forget at this moment. There's another moment in the film where the granddaughter, only 12 years old or so, she's sitting at with her head down just outside of the trailer. And grandma comes over to her, ask her how it was. The 3 days had not gone, three days had just gone by. School had already begun and she hasn't been going to school. And she says, "Oh, I don't have the paper and pencil that I'm required to have." So grandma has to find paper and pencil somehow or other so that she can continue school. Well, as it develops, she seems to be the most promising student in the whole family, enough so that there's a good possibility that she may even get into college. But still, she's only 13 or 14 at this point, right? And we got news not so long ago, she's pregnant, which puts an end to her dreams. I mean, millions of people, I don't know, tens of millions of people who have seen that film now, you know, now they know what they didn't know before. They know what poverty is really like from having experienced it through people who were experiencing it. That's so important in itself. And so we've got many calls from people who ask us, "Well, what can we do? How can we help?" And so there's a foundation through which they can contribute. And we learn directly how these children who come from a family of illiterate people, you know, and therefore are ill-disposed toward learning much of anything, right? But then they go to a school where even if they had better education at home, there was nothing for them to learn because the school is just dedicated to improving their SAT scores. So to learn how to take an SAT score is not to get an education. All that becomes very clear in the film.